Hey guys, this is Dr. Sangeeta and welcome back to another lecture of Dental Paathshala where we help you understand and learn dentistry better and easy. And today's topic, we are going to talk about the tumor wherein there is increase in the cell number. So without further ado, let's get started. And welcome back to our 10 in 10 series where we cover each topic under 10 headings in 10 minutes. And today's topic is the squamous cell carcinoma. So the squamous cell carcinoma is also known as oral cancer because this is the most malignant cancer which is commonly seen in the oral tissues. And before we get started, make sure you subscribe to our channel and click on the bell icon so that you don't miss any of our future videos. Talking about squamous cell carcinoma, as the name suggests, carcinoma is a term which is given for the malignant neoplasm of the epithelial tissues. Sarcoma, if we use, is a malignant neoplasm of the connective tissue. On the other hand, if we use OMA word, that means it is a benign cancer. So when we are talking about carcinoma, that means that is a malignant neoplasm of the epithelium. And if we are talking about squamous cell carcinoma, that means there is going to be the carcinoma malignant neoplasm of the stratified squamous epithelial cells. Now what happens in case of a tumor or a cancer? There is increase in the cell number. These cells, they keep on increasing. So these tumor cells, actually they look similar to the normal tissue cells. So herein, the tumor cells are going to look like the stratified squamous epithelium. And these cells will multiply in number and they will invade into the connective tissue. So they will, via lymphatics, they will spread to the other parts of the body. And that is how malignancy word means they are going to metastasize. So the metastasis will be seen. That means if cancer is here, but it is invading into the other tissues. So that means when there is a cancer of the mouth, what happens? There is also spread from the lymph node. It affects lymph nodes. Then it can go to neck. It can cause the metastasis. So this is how we talk about the malignant neoplasm. Now, coming back to squamous cell carcinoma. Now, you all have seen the Mukesh video before the cinemas. That play in the cinemas. What happens? Mostly, most of the times, the tobacco is the factor which causes the oral cancer, right? So the etiology being is the tobacco. So tobacco contains 300 carcinogens. So tobacco has got aromatic hydrocarbon, benzopyrenes, as well as tobacco specific nitrosamines. So we have tobacco specific nitrosamines. Now these tobacco specific nitrosamine are so many number. We have N-nitrose, nornicotine, N-nitrose, pyrrolidine, N-nitrose, dimethylamine. So like that, so many nitrose, N-nitrose are there. So these N-nitrose, they have the potential to change the DNA. So what they do? They cause some changes. They actually make O6-methylguanine, which interferes with the DNA replication, which causes the mutation. And this is the main part which is causing the cancer. Now also alcohol is associated with the cancer. Mostly it is seen when the alcohol is consumption is consumed with the tobacco. So what happens? Because of the both, they have this additive effect of nitrosonornicotine. So that is how it is going to cross the mucous membrane, and there will be a liver cirrhosis. Then all these disease may be associated with the development of cancer because they damage the liver, right? And because liver cannot detoxify all of the cariogenic chemicals which are present in the blood. Also UV radiation, we have seen actinic radiation. And solar keratosis, which is present in the vermilion border of the lip. Basically what happens in case of people like us, the brown color skin or the black color skin people, we have heavy melanin pigment. Now the purpose of melanin pigment is to provide the protection against the radiations. But if the protection is less in case of white people, so they may develop the cancer. Again, some viruses like human papilloma virus, HIV virus also, because this is immunodeficient. And HSV virus type 2 can also, herpes simplex 2 can also have the malignancy potential. So, talking about human papilloma, HSV, Epstein-Barr virus, HIV virus, all these viruses. And then also some of the conditions like candidiasis. Now, candidiasis, what happens? We have the chronic hyperplastic type of candidiasis. So, candidiasis, in one kind of candidiasis, there is hyperplastic. So, tissue keep on multiplying. So, in that has got the potential of malignancy, syphilis. Now also in the syphilis, there is a syphilitic correlation between the syphilitis glossitis and the oral cancer. So the syphilis, which is involved with the oral tissues, then also pre-malignant lesions. So many pre-malignant lesions we know that can cause the malignancy, like OSMF, arthroplakia, lichen planus, leucoplakia. So many pre-malignant lesion, they can cause the cancer. So this is about the etiology. Coming to clinical feature, now how does it looks like? How this squamous cell carcinoma look like? It is usually, when it starts, it is a white red asymptomatic nodule. Okay, this is just a nodule which can be red or white in color. But what happens later on? It enlarges the growth is very fast, and it grows into exophytic invasive indurated lesions, indurated ulcer, and the ulcer has got elevated margin. So if you look at the margin of the ulcer, they are elevated, or we can say everted margin, and it is painful in some cases, painless in some cases, and it bleeds profusely. So we have some locations for squamous cell carcinoma, like in the lip, tongue, floor of the mouth. So this is sequencing. So the majorly squamous cell SCC is seen in the lips, then tongue if we talk about lateral border of the tongue, lip if we talk about the lower lip, then floor of the mouth, so like that, and then soft palate, gingiva and buccal mucosa. So lips, if you can see, because of the actinic radiation, the vermilion borders of the lips are affected, especially if we talk about the lower lip, right? So in the lower lip, in the vermilion border, there can be an everted, rolled out, indurated ulcer. Now there may be pain, it will bleed, there can be paresthesia, and because of that patient, because of the indurations, patient may find difficulty in the speech, and this lesion can grow up to 2 centimeters. There is slow metastasis in case of SCC of lip due to the keratotic, it can also be due to the keratotic leucoplakia as well as actinic keratitis. Now, coming to the lesion of the tongue, which is the second most common lesion of squamous cell carcinoma, it occurs in the high-risk areas in the mouth. So, we have a U-shaped zone, the high-risk area. Now, this U-shaped zone, it starts from the lateral border of the tongue, then floor of the mouth, then the retromolar pad, and then it goes the soft tissue and it crosses the other side. So it makes a U-shaped zone. Then we have the dorsum of the tongue is actually resistance. The squamous cell carcinoma, it doesn't happen on the dorsal surface of the tongue. Also, because of the cancer, there can be fixation of the tongue to the floor of the mouth. The patient won't be even able to lift the tongue. And what happens when it is causing cancer in the tongue? It can drain into the lymph nodes. It can spread via lymph nodes. So it can go into submandibular area. It can go up to the jugular areas. So the floor of the mouth, anterior and especially lateral floor of the mouth is involved. This is most fatal and aggressive. Why? Because when it occurs in the floor of the mouth, so it is going to spread via the lymphatic spread. It will spread it will metastasize. So it is going to involve the other organ via lymphatic. It is going to spread to the neck. So this is actually most fatal. How it looks like? Nodular, ulcerated, indurated. So what you have to remember is the lesion is has got indurated margins. So there is an ulcer which has got elevated surface of the margin of the ulcer, and everted, either it is going to be elevated or everted margin. So initially it looks like white or red asymptomatic because of the keratin, right? And later on, it can become an ulcer. So initially, it is just a nodule. Later on, it can become ulcer. Talking about the palate, usually it is seen in the soft palate. It is rarely seen in the hard palate. Then because of the reverse smoking nowadays, because this has got a female predilection, because female are more attracted to smoking, reverse smoking nowadays. And then erythroplakic plaque, and it is ulceration, and as well as red color patch in the palate. So arthroplakic plaque plus ulceration is seen in the palate. Then buccal mucosa, mostly in the posterior part along the occlusal line, it is involved. painful indurated ulcer again, it can perforate and come out from the cheek also. So that is in case of squamous cell carcinoma. It can also involve the gingiva, especially mandibular. Attached gingiva is more frequently involved. And if we do the extraction, what happens? Because of the extraction, it can spread. You see, suppose if the carcinoma is there, associated in the some gingival part. Gingival enlargement is there. After you do the extraction, it can spread through the bone. So it can actually invade inside. So we should not do the extraction. Then come to radiographic appearance. It looks like there is a ill-defined hazy border. So the border are not well-defined in the case of carcinoma. Like the cyst we talked about, cyst we had very well-defined border. But in case of carcinoma, they are not well-defined. They are hazy. So they are kind of a blur, ill-defined borders with appearance. We call it the moth-eaten appearance. Because of the expansion of the carcinoma, there can be expansion and destruction of the cortical plates, and even the pathologic fracture can happen. So histopathologic feature, any carcinoma, once we look at, it is going to have. See, any malignant neoplasm will have dysplastic changes, will have differentiation. So there is going to be three type of epithelium. One is the well-defined stratified squamous epithelium that will exactly look same like the stratified squamous epithelial cells. Moderately differentiated will not look exactly like, but the mitosis activity is little bit increased in the moderately. Poor defined stratified squamous epithelial will have so much of extensive mitotic activity. The cell are going to multiply like anything, so fast speed, but they are not the cells, if you look at, they are not like the stratified squamous epithelial cells. So it is hard and difficult to differentiate. Now what do we see in case of differentiation? We see some dysplastic changes. What kind of changes we see? What happens because of the keratinization? These cells, they are doing excessive of keratinization. So what happens? There are keratinization happening, and because of this, keratin pearls are formed, right? Now, these can actually go from the epithelium, it can invade into the connective tissue also. So, what happens when the tumor cells invade into the connective tissue? We call the epithelial in the connective tissue, like we call the epithelial islands. So, also we see the cellular pleomorphism. So, the number, shape of the cellular of the nucleus also changes. The nuclear hyperchromatism, nuclear, I have become more chromatin content is there in the nucleus, and the cells keep on increasing rapidly, which is a feature of a neoplasm, a tumor, that the cells keep on enlarging. Then the metastasis, it is going to invade into the other tissues. So we will study the TNM staging in the separate video. So TNM staging means tumor, and the size of the tumor, N for lymph node and M for metastasis. Then the treatment is basically the excision, radiotherapy, as well as the chemotherapy. And with the tobacco cessation programs, we can aware the community about the relationship of tobacco as well as the oral cancer, and that is how we can prevent the oral cancer. So TNM staging we are going to talk about in the separate video. So this is about the squamous cell carcinoma, the ulcer. Initially it is a white or red asymptomatic nodule, but later on it becomes indurated, elevated marginated ulcer, and it can be painful in later on stages. The location is the lower lip is involved frequently, first one, and the tongue can be the lateral surface of the tongue, border of the tongue, floor of the mouth can be involved. So guys, this is about the squamous cell carcinoma, the most common kind of oral cancer. I hope that you guys have enjoyed the video. So if you have enjoyed the video, then give it a thumbs up. Also, you can comment in the comment section below, and there is a link in the description box below to support us on the Paytm as well as on PayPal to make free videos for you guys and to make free notes. So guys, till then, take care, keep reading, keep studying, stay motivated. I will see you soon in the next video.